guy's grabbing our wrist, right? I'm gonna either, you can either arm drag from here, going across the body and attack him, or I just want you guys to know that I'm clear, which is I pull my hand to my body first, and I punch that hand off while keeping that hand close to my body. So I'm wrestling, he grabs my wrist, I get mine to my body, and I punch his off. Keep his wrist, now we can attack from here, right? It's like we said at the start, I'm not gonna reach, he gets out of position, reaches, I take control, now I'm in a 2-on-1, I can wrestle. If he's got a hard grip and this is not coming right away, be patient. Keep this close to your body. Do not let it get away from you. This is where you get into trouble. Arm drag, snap downs, fakes, and all sorts of stuff happening when arms are away from body. Here, he doesn't have much control. I have his control, right? He may have my wrist, but he doesn't have options here like he would if it's here. Here, I can fight and wrestle, okay? So wrists, hold to your body, punch off. Look at your arms. Two hands and one wrist here. Same ideas, right? One, you can pull single from here. Not a great option, but still an option. And it's the same idea. I want to get this close to my body and start fighting one wrist off. Again, when this happens, I start getting into trouble. This has to be your option. Once I get one wrist off, now we're one-on-one, cross punch, start circling away, wrestling out. Again, the offense really for the wrists here. I like wrists as I've gotten older. I think they're very safe attack points, and you can control a lot of the time. So, you know, if you're looking wrist series, you have a lot of grab offense here, or a lot of, you know, pull, drop in, leg attack type of stuff. It's some good time to invest in the offensive series like that. But I'm more focused right now on this guy grabs our wrist, punch him off. He goes two wrists to one, punch off, secure the other wrist. Right? Arms close to our body. One note, the right arms close, they're not so far back they can't defend, right? If he takes a shot, and my hands are here, I can't block him. So I need to be able to have him out about face far apart. He drops, I can get the hands down and block him here. But I'm not reaching, I'm never coming off of my body, unless it's easy score. So, last thing is inside tie-ups. Elbow tie-ups. I think that's the other ones. And that and probably collar tie are the two big positions in high school wrestling. So I have an inside tie here, and he's controlling my elbow. I need to get my hand palm on his bicep and push down, lower to control. Here. Right? Once I'm here, I've got it. I can keep it. I don't need to let go here. His elbow control is no longer there. Whenever we're way up high here, he's pulling us in, and I can't get my wrist back, I'm in trouble. Or arm back, my wrist. So I drop my palm down and get to the bottom part of his tricep. Now I have control of his arm again. He doesn't have my elbow. He's touching my elbow, but he can't control my elbow here. Right? So we're hand fighting. I go inside, I'm high. I drop down. Here's my elbow. So for my inside top control, I can go. If we have elbow control and he's inside tied, just like I was saying, I can't let him get my arm extended, and I can't let him low on my arm. He starts tying me up, I grab, pull, and shrug that arm into my body to take away his tie. So instead of letting this go and pushing off, I'm pulling this in and I'm tight. Side, I can wrestle. I'm dominating the tie, being aggressive. Again, it's basic hand fighting stuff, not super high powered offensive stuff. When you chain these hand fighting positions together and you win over time, that's when you start putting points up because he's never in a spot to A, threaten you, and B, he's always in a spot where you have potential to score. Last couple things out there coming to mind. Last two things. So, one is if he does collar tie you, there is a way you can get to a wrist from here, and it kind of plays into the second one. plays in the second one. It's how you grab his wrist and position of your arm. So when I'm straight up and down with my arm, I have the ability to roll and take control here. So again, here, I'm grabbing my head, I grab that wrist and roll it down with my arm, arm straight. The next thing Kyle Snyder does really well is if I'm using a hand fighting position and I can't be aggressive because I'm very vulnerable to an attack, I turn my wrists out like I'm holding like a waitress or waiter, you know, serving something, and I push them off of my body. This is probably one of the few times going away from the body is okay. So you collar ties or whatever, I get my elbow down, wrist up, and I extend my arms explosively and push them off. And this is really good, like, you know, maybe I got backed up, I got to do a scramble. He comes up and he's really aggressively moving me, and I'm kind of losing his hand. I push him away, I regain control of the center. I go back to wrestling, I live to fight another day. Now, chaining 3 and 4 of those together looks like you're stalling, so it's not something you want to consistently do. But, again, if I'm getting beat in condition where he starts undermining me, pulling me around, I'm not doing so hot, and then I take my position, catch his wrist, go down. Again, the difference between rolling and pushing is your wrist position here. Huge difference. It's like nearly impossible to get enough strength when your wrist is up. You have to turn it down almost. You guys got it? So, again, that's a lot of hand.